Let's talk about some of the options we have in Scribeline. When we click on Draw Scribeline, this is going to give us ways that we can clean up our walls without having to do it manually. We can go into here and we have multiple options. Offset with taper, rake, and then two different scribe tab options. Offset with taper, this is going to allow us to tell it a max depth with a taper length. It is going to go ahead and it's going to create a tapered line and then try to follow the high spot on the wall from both directions. So I'm going to select my two walls and hit done. If we zoom in here and look, you're going to notice that there's a line here. It drew a taper line in and it then followed it up, rode the high spot, which is right there, and then finished it out to the corner, doing it on the same way on the other side. This gives us an ability to basically have two wall lines rather than having multiple, which is what's already there. The one nice thing about any of these commands is it does turn the old wall into cabinets, so we can get rid of that pretty easily later, but it does leave those so that we can see where the high and the lows exist. Now, the next option that we're going to cover is rake. Now, within rake, we can tell it whatever we want. Now, I'm going to make this a little more extreme to show you, but basically, we are going to go ahead and click on our wall. I'm going to click on my wall towards the corner, and I'm going to tell it to offset it in or out. Obviously in. We're now going to go ahead and include the other wall and hit done. Now, way more extreme than we're going to ever use, but you can see it offsets it over two and down two, and it's going to do that and then run it all the way out to tight in the corners. Ideally, we are not going to ever do it that much. We're probably going to do something more like a quarter of an inch, tie the two walls in, and hit done. You can see it moved it in a quarter of an inch, and then ran it all the way out until it's nice and tight. Now, it's going to do that on both walls, so it gives us that nice touch point out here at the end, but then also we'll bring it over to give us some relief for our backsplash to cover. The last option is going to be scribe tabs. Now, in this case, we're going to do the dual scribe tabs. We're going to do a quarter inch depth, and this is going to be a 3-inch ear. I'm going to tell it where the two walls are, and I'm now going to zoom in and tell it where the end of this wall is, and I'm going to tell it where the end of this wall is. This now creates two ears that are 3 inches in length, and it's also then going to give us a quarter inch gap. It's going to then go ahead and straight line it from there all the way up to the corner. Turns the old walls into a cabinet line so we can get rid of them easy later. Now it gives us the ability to see if a quarter of an inch is a little bit more in some spots or tighter in others. Any of these will not allow you to actually operate the function if the high spot were to protrude into the new line. But this gives us a nice way to create an ear without creating anything too complex. Very quick, very easy, very nice way to create your lines.